This is a video from section 3.4. We're going to look at the chain rule. If g is differentiable at x and f is differentiable at g of x, then the composite function capital F, which is equal to f composed with g, defined by capital F of x is equal to f of g of x, is differentiable at x, and capital F prime is given by capital F prime of x is equal to f prime of g of x times g prime of x. So I like to think of the chain rule this way. I'm going to take the derivative of the outside function and evaluate it at the inside function. Take that result and multiply by the derivative of the inside function. And with that, the directions say find the derivative of each function. Suppose f of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 to the fifth. And in each one of these, I want to identify the outside function as well as the inside function before I start taking the derivative. The outside function is h of x is equal to x to the fifth. The inside function is g of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4. Now, h of x equals x to the fifth, and so h prime of x is equal to 5x to the fourth. That's just power rule. So when I look at f prime of x, I'm going to take the derivative of the outside function and evaluate it at the inside function. So in other words, I look up here and I'm going to replace x with 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4. So notice here I have 5 times 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 to the fourth. And then I want to multiply by the derivative of the inside function, which is the derivative of 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 with respect to x. And so this is 5 times 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 to the fourth times 2 times 3x squared, right? The 2 just went along for the ride. And then the derivative of x cubed with respect to x is 3x squared minus 5 times 2x. 5 went along for the ride, and I just had to take the derivative of x squared. And so this is equal to 5 times 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 to the fourth times. And by the way, if you notice, I factored out a 2x. So I multiplied by 2x times the quantity 3x minus 5. But 5 times 2x is 10x. So f prime of x is 10x times 3x minus 5 times 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 4 to the fourth. That's problem number 7. Problem number 11. G of t is equal to 1 over 2t plus 1 to the third, which I'm going to write as 2t plus 1 to the negative 3. So my inside function is h of t is 2t plus 1. My outside function is f of t is t to the negative 3. And by the way, f prime of t is negative 3 t to the negative fourth. That's just power rule. So when I go ahead and find g prime of t, I need to look to the outside function and replace t with 2t plus 1. So we're going to look at the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside function. So this should give me a negative 3 times 2t plus 1 to the negative 4. And I'm going to take that result and multiply by the derivative of the inside function with respect to t. So in other words, I'm going to multiply by the derivative of 2t plus 1 with respect to t. But this is negative 3 times 2t plus 1 to the negative 4 times 2. And if I do a little simplifying, g prime of t is negative 6 times, negative 6 divided by 2t plus 1 to the fourth. If we take a look at 15, g of x is e to the x squared minus x. The inside function is h of x is x squared minus x. The outside function is f of x is equal to e to the x. And the derivative of e to the x is e to the x. And if you notice, I'm going to replace x with the inside function. So when I look at g prime of x, I get e raised to the x squared minus x, right? So in other words, I get the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside function. And I'm going to take that result and multiply by the derivative of the inside function with respect to x. So I'm going to multiply by the derivative of x squared minus x with respect to x. And this tells me f prime of x is equal to 2x minus 1, that's the derivative of the inside function, times e raised to the x squared minus x. So that's the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside function. That's number 15. Now, I want to go over something. Suppose I let y equal a to the x. A is greater than 0. A does not equal 1. And so this is e to the natural log of a to the x, which is equal to e raised to the x times natural log of a. Now, same game. What's the inside function? We're going to look at the chain rule. And what's the outside function? Now, the inside function is f of x, let's call it g of x, is equal to x times natural log of a. The outside function is f of x is equal to e to the x. And so f prime of x is equal to e to the x. And so therefore, when I want y prime, I'm going to take e, the derivative of the outside function, and now keep in mind, I'm going to replace x with x times ln of a. So here I'm going to write x times ln of a, or natural log of a. And I'm going to take that result and multiply by the derivative of the inside function, which is x times natural log of a. And so this is e to the x times natural log of a times natural log of a. But if we go back, e to the x times natural log of a is equal to a to the x. So this can be expressed as a to the x times natural log of a. And so therefore, y prime is a to the x times natural log of a. Now, therefore, the derivative of a to the x with respect to x is equal to a to the x times natural log of a. So I want to look at some examples that involve that. And so with that in mind, I'm going to take a look at number 16. Suppose y equals 5 raised to the root x. Okay? Now, I need an outside function and I need an inside function. Now, my inside function is g of x is equal to square root of x. My outside function is f of x is equal to 5 to the x. Now, we just learned that f prime of x is 5 to the x times natural log of the base. Okay? Now, I want y prime. So I'm going to get 5 raised to, now I'm going to replace x with the inside function. So in other words, I'm going to replace x with square root of x. I'm going to multiply by natural log of 5. And then I'm going to multiply by the derivative of the inside function, which is square root of x, with respect to x. So this is 5 to the root x times natural log of 5 times the derivative of x to the 1/2 with respect to x, which is 5 to the root x, natural log of 5, times 1/2 x to the negative 1/2, like so, which is 5 to the root x, natural log of 5, times 1 over 2x to the 1/2, right? And so, therefore, y prime is 5 to the root x, natural log of 5, divided by x to the 1/2 can be written as square root of x. So I'm going to divide by 2 square root of x. And that was problem number 16. Now, let's take a look at problem number 26. So f of t is equal to 2 raised to the t to the third. What's my inside function? What's my outside function? So I tend to do this first when we're first learning the chain rule. So it gives you an idea of what's going on. Now, my inside function, I'll call g of t, is equal to t to the third. My outside function is f of t is 2 to the t. And keep in mind that f prime of t is 2 to the t times natural log of the base, which in this case is 2. So if I want f prime of t, we should probably call that h of t, so we're not mixing that up. So we'll let this be h of t and h prime of t. Why? Because f already got used. Now, I'm going to write 2 raised to the... Now, remember, I'm going to replace t with that inside function. Remember, it's the derivative of the outside function, but we're going to evaluate it at the inside function. So I'm going to put t to the third there times natural log of 2 times the derivative of t to the third with respect to t. The derivative of t to the third with respect to t is 3t squared. So I get 3t squared times 2 raised to the t to the third times natural log of 2. And this is f prime of t. That was problem 26. If we take a look at problem number 29, and that'll be the last one for this video. On 29, we have r of t is equal to 10 raised to the 2 square root of t, which is equal to 10 raised to the 2t to the 1 half. Okay? Now, so again, I'm going to look at the inside function. And I'm going to look at the outside function. Now, my inside function is g of t is 2t to the 1 half. My outside function is f of t is 10 to the t. So remember, f prime of t is 10 to the t times natural log of 10, right? And so if I want r prime of t, I'm going to get the derivative of the outside function, right, evaluated at the inside function. So in other words, I'm going to replace that t with 2t to the 1 half. So I'm going to put a 2t to the 1 half up here. And I'm going to multiply by the derivative of 2t to the 1 half with respect to t. Just like this. And so r prime of t is, oh, and then by the way, don't forget, we got to put a natural log of 10 there. So let me just quickly put that in. So I'm going to put natural log of 10 and then take the derivative of 2t to the 1 half. Now we're good. Okay. If we come over here, we get 10 raised to the 2t to the 1 half. Let me give myself room here. Times natural log of 10 times. Now, the derivative of 2t to the 1 half is 2 times 1 half times t to the negative 1 half. So r prime of t is, the 2's cancel, okay? And in the denominator, we're going to get square root of t. Remember, t to the 1 half is the same as square root of t. In the numerator, we're going to get 10 raised to the 2 square root of t, natural log of 10. Now, this is one of those you want to double check with your instructor. This can be written this way as well. So you could write 10 squared to the square root of t times natural log of 10 divided by square root of t. And 10 squared is 100. And so you could also write this as r prime of t is 100 raised to the square root of t times natural log of 10 divided by square root of t. And we're going to conclude there. That'll conclude this video for section 3.4. We worked on the following problems. We worked on 7, 11, 15, 16, 26, and 29. Okay, thank you.